I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Wait, what?
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Oh no! Stop! No! Damn it, die! No! No! No!
I was trapped. There was no way out.
Shit, where the hell am I going? Fuck.
Follow the light. You are hurt. Should go into the light. You are only safe there. Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light. I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important
thing. Oh, shit.
The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Okay.
Now you'll die.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Shit. shit.
I can keep this up forever.
Shit.
Baby, just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here. on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Hi. Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Mead, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I can get an interview?
Look, Mr. Maine, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose. I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. Mm-hmm.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
The hell?
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did. Hello? Mr. Stuckey?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
hell?
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This...
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
The Andersons, they're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They want...
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Bad man here. I'm KBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Hello? Anyone here?
The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier.
For a moment, the oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Shit.
I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island.
Power cable goes to that shed over there.
The water was clear but dark. It looked very deep.
Oh, shit.
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
There's probably a fuse box or a generator in the shed.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
The lights are on! Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay, I'll look around a bit.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again. It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Alice? Honey?
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn it, Alice! You... Everyone keeps...
Hey! Just hear me out! There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No! It's not like that! That's not...
The fuck?
Alan?
I don't! Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice! God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through. Damn it. Alice?
Alice!
The cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alan! Where are you? Help!
Alice, I'm coming! It's all right, I'm coming!
No!
What the hell?
Oh, no!
Keep going, Alan. Wake up!
Alice?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find